Gotta take a break because someone has to use the restroom.
So now you just have to believe in yourself and tell yourself that you are ready for it. Howdy everybody, my name is Kaylee. I am a recent graduate from Texas A&M and I currently work as a junior content copywriter at an advertising agency in Houston, Texas. Today I decided to film a little bonus video because my office is currently working from home again, or like some of us are, because of the recent spike in COVID. We've just decided to stay home and stay safe. So I'm filming a little work from home vlog today. I hope you guys enjoy it. I will be leaving around lunchtime to go get some lunch with some of my coworkers, because we've had this planned since before the office decided to shut down again. So that is a time that I will be leaving, but other than that, we are working from home today, so here we go. And today's work from home outfit includes this old battalion t-shirt and some black biker shorts, just to stay comfortable. I'll put something on before I go out to lunch because I'm not wearing this out in public. Coworker keeps napping. Gotta take a break because someone has to use the restroom. You might be able to hear him in the background, but apparently today is the day, the first day I'm working from home, today is the day that my apartment complex decides to replace all of the shrubs outside of her units. So I get to hear some landscaping while I work today. But anyways, just an update on what I've been doing. Stanley, my coworker, has been napping. He's been super helpful, but I have been the lead on this project, super exciting, but the due date is coming up, and so a lot of the different subtasks have just been done, and today is just a lot of reviewing, getting final edits done, and then there are some things that are still being started and finished today. But yeah, it's been pretty chill, just doing some editing of things that have already been written, so. So I did not realize that it was already lunchtime. So me and some other coworkers are going to this taco place in Houston called La Vibra, to go and get some tacos for lunch. So off we go. Oh my goodness, guys, those tacos were so good. Kind of want to go take a nap, but gotta finish out the work day first. Time to head back home. Howdy, y'all. Just taking a quick break from work to hop on and talk about something that I've been thinking about these past couple weeks as I've been the lead on this project, and that is imposter syndrome. It's very real because your girl was feeling it. I was like, when I was first told that I was going to be the lead on this project, I was like, excuse me, what? I am an entry-level employee, and I've been working here for 5 months. I mean, now that I think about it, it's kind of a long time, but enough to be leading a project? Like, I just felt like I was not going to do good, and like the whole time I had this spreadsheet going to keep track of things and how progress was going, and there was just so much red on it for things not being done yet that I was stressing myself out. I was like, this is it. I'm not good at managing things. I just can't. I'm not made for this. Like, I can't do it. And things weren't going to be done on time, and they weren't going to be good, and I was just getting really worried and a little frustrated with myself that I was feeling this way. I was like, Kaylee, you know, I was like, I just had to tell myself, I was like, she wouldn't have given you this responsibility if she didn't think you weren't ready, because my director is currently out of office, and so that's why she sort of passed these things along to us. And so I was like, Kaylee, if she didn't think you weren't ready, she was gonna give it to somebody else. And this project is like more in my wheelhouse of like my interests and things. And so that was one reason why it was given to me. But then I was also told that this project could be something that we pitch to other clients and things that we could do for other people. So I was like, so that means this is the first like big thing like this that we've done that we're gonna be showing to other clients. I was like, that just added even more stress. What? But we are coming to a conclusion on this project, and while the imposter syndrome hit in for the first little bit of it, when it all came together and I was just seeing it holistically now instead of as its separate pieces that all still needed to be done, I felt so much better. And also just my teammates just picking me up and being like, heck yeah, Kaylee, you do got this. You wouldn't, like, obviously you wouldn't be given this responsibility if you weren't ready for it. Plus, they were all there. They were like, we got your back, Kaylee. Like, we're gonna help you. They were all incredible. So, imposter syndrome, very real. But just tell yourself, you wouldn't be put in this situation if someone didn't think you weren't ready for it. So now you just have to believe in yourself and tell yourself that you are ready for it, because you are ready for it. And the more you tell yourself, the more you'll believe it. So yep, just my little 2 cents on that. Time to get back to work. After 6 hours of working, we finally got all of the pieces for this project done. Now I just have to go through and make sure that they all seem cohesive and will flow well together, since we had multiple people writing them. But I don't know if my brain can handle that right now. It's been a very long day. But this is also kind of the only thing I have to do. Me and another guy are working on something else together, but unfortunately that thing wasn't able to be done through Google Drive, and so we aren't both able to work on it at the same time. I kind of want to see if we could like
just hop on a Google Meets and just, I can watch him fill the things in because I don't want to think about this project anymore today. Yep. I'm gonna see if we can do that.
When your computer dies. Well, you guys, we are now done with the workday. It is around 5:30.
I have now closed my laptop, and Stanley and I are about to go to the dog park. But just a little update on the rest of the stuff that I did.
Other guy that I'm working with, we just started filling out our slides.
We still have some stuff to do on them, but these are slides that are gonna be presented to one of our bosses. So, gotta make sure they look clean. We both recently graduated, and so we were both like, we feel like we're back in college making these slides over like Google Slides. Since we both graduated during COVID, it's wild. But yeah, this is also, oh my gosh, it's just so crazy. This week has been wild. Major senses of deja vu in that I was in school in the spring of 2020 when we went home and never went back, and everything was just online, and we were talking with people over the phone and doing stuff through Google Drive, so we could all work collaboratively, and just everything was online and from our own homes. And now it's kind of back to that, which is a little scary. Luckily I have Stan to keep me company. But yeah, that's why we were both just like, this is major deja vu, back in college, making PowerPoint slides, and we felt like we were gonna get graded. It was just a really weird feeling. But yeah, it's just crazy how a year and a few months later, we thought we were over it. We're back. So yeah, doing my part to stay safe and not spread any sicknesses. I feel totally fine. I'm just staying here for safety. Our whole office is getting deep cleaned later today. So yeah, it's a fun time in the USA. But anyways, away from that, yeah, it was honestly kind of good to be back working at home. I don't know which one I prefer, working from home or working in the office, which is why I would like to give like a hybrid schedule a try and like have some days of the week where we go into the office and some days where we stay at home. I think that would really be really beneficial because me and some of my other coworkers have talked about how being at home, we were able to like get other house chores done, just like take a break from like work and go get housework done, and then be able to come back to the work like refreshed. Plus I just love being able to sit here with Stanley. I hate leaving him during the day, and it always makes me so happy to come back home. I'm very grateful that my office allows dogs to come in, so that's really helpful to having to go in every day. But I wish there were some days where I could just sit home and work in my pajamas from my couch, curled up in my blanket. We are currently going to the office every single day, so this was a nice change of pace to just get to work from home. Again, since that's how I was hired, working from home, and then went to the office. Now working from home for a few days again. But yep, that is enough of my 5:30 in the evening.
after a full days of work rambling, and I'm gonna end the video off. So thank you guys for watching this fun little work from home vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This will be just a little bonus video that I decided to film. So stay tuned for the regularly scheduled content every Wednesday and Sunday. Thank you guys for watching. You're amazing. I will see you guys next time. And remember, do what makes you happy. Bye. Say bye, Stanley. Are you ready to eat and then go to the park? You ready to eat? Bye, y'all.